Welcome class, I am Dr. Masooma. Today I am going to teach you practical, that is examination of hemocytometer and RBC count. First of all, you should know that what is hemocytometer. Heme means blood, cyto means cell, and meter means count. It means it is an instrument that is used to count the blood cells. It consists of different parts. I will show you one by one. It consists of RBC pipette, WBC pipette, Neubauer chamber, and cover slip. I will explain these part one by one. First of all, RBC pipette. RBC pipette consists of a glass stem. This is the glass stem having capillary tube with a marking from 0.5 to 1. From the tip of the pipette to the mark 1, there are 10 equal divisions having no specific mercury unit. This glass stem widens into a bulb containing a red bead. You can see over here. The stem has capacity of 1 part and the bulb has capacity of 100 parts. What is the function of that bulb? As you can see, there is a red bead. This red bead indicates that this is the pipette that is used for the red blood cell count or for the calculation of red blood cell, and it has a capacity of 100 parts. Second, its function is that it is used to mix the blood with the diluting substance. The third part is that this bulb narrows into a capillary tube. You can see this was the bulb and this bulb narrows into a capillary tube. This small stem is connected to a plastic tube which ends in a red colored plastic mouthpiece. So this is all about RBC pipette. If you have any question about the practical, you can ask me. The next part of the hemocytometer is the Neubauer chamber. Neubauer chamber, this is the Neubauer chamber. It is a thick glass slide. If you hold it, you will feel that it is a thick glass slide. Having a central platform which is divided into two parts with the horizontal part of the egg-shaped groove. You can see that this is a horizontal part of the egg-shaped groove and two grooves are over the lateral side of the central platform. One can ask you in the vivas or practical, what is the Neubauer chamber? This central platform, this is called Neubauer chamber. This part, this is the Neubauer chamber, and this hole is the slide. Over in the center, there is a central platform which is called the Neubauer chamber. Over it, we count red blood cells. On the sides of this lateral grooves, there are two ridges. These are elevated. These ridges are used, we put cover slip over these ridges and they have a height of about 1 by 10 millimeter or 0.1 millimeter. This is the height, that is the standard height of the Neubauer chamber that we use in the calculation of the blood cells. It will always remain the same, that is 1 by 10 millimeter or 0.1 millimeter. Okay. When we put the cover slip over the ridges, the cover slip will be elevated from the platform for a height of about 0.1 millimeter. This was all about Neubauer chamber. Then is the cover slip. This is the cover slip. Always hold the cover slip from the sides, from the edges. We should not hold the cover slip like this. Why? Because if we hold like this, our fingerprints will come over the cover slip. So we hold the cover slip like this and we put it over the ridges of the Neubauer chamber. Like this. If we examine this Neubauer chamber under the microscope, we found that there are grids or there are markings. I will explain this chamber or these squares of the Neubauer chamber after a while. If we see the Neubauer chamber under the microscope, we can see such picture. The Neubauer chamber is divided into three small square in the horizontal direction and three small square in the vertical direction on each platform. The size of these three small square is equal to 3 millimeter in vertical direction and in horizontal direction. If the three small squares are equal to 3 mm, what does it mean? It means one small square is equal to 1 mm. So, if we calculate the area of one small square, we take this small square and we have come over here, then this one small square is equal to 1 millimeter. If we calculate the area of this one small square, what is the formula of area of square? That is equal to length into breadth. Length is 1 mm, breadth is 1 mm. So what is the area? 1 millimeter square. If we calculate the volume of one small square, what is the formula of volume? It is area multiplied by depth. What is the area? We have calculated over here, that is 1 millimeter square multiplied by 1 by 10. From where this 1 by 10 came? This is the 1 by 10 depth of the Neubauer chamber, that is the standard depth of the Neubauer chamber. Whenever we use the depth of the Neubauer chamber, we will use 1 over 10 or 0.1 millimeter. Now, when we do the calculation, 1 multiplied by 1, this will come to 1 over 10 or 0.1 cubic millimeter. So, the area of one small square is equal to 1 millimeter square and volume of one small square is equal to 0.1 cubic millimeter. For the calculation of WBCs, we use four corner squares of this Neubauer chamber. But for the calculation of red blood cell, we use the central square. So, in this practical, we will focus on this central square. Central square. If we see under the microscope, this central square is marked with three lines on each side. These lines distinguish this central square from the squares which are present over the corners. And this central square, which is used for the counting of the red blood cell, is also different from the corner square in the way that these corner squares, they are divided into four small square. But this central square, it is divided into five small square. And these scales are called as medium size scale. This is again an important Viva question that someone can ask you that tell me over the newborn chamber, what are the medium size scale? The scales which are present in the central scale that we use for the counting of the red blood cells are called medium size scale. And the scale that we use for the counting of the WBC, they are called small size scale. Now, if we take one small scale of this central scale, now think about it, this is the central scale of that newborn chamber. We have taken that central scale. Now, we are taking one small scale of this central scale. There are five small scales. If you take one small scale, it will be equal to 1 over 5 millimeter. This small scale is further subdivided into four small scales. That is, this small scale is further subdivided into four small scales. Like this, I have tried to divide them. So, this one small scale is equal to 1 by 5 millimeter. It is further divided into four small scale in each direction. So, what will we do? 1 by 5 multiplied by 1 by 4. It is equal to 1 by 20 millimeter scale. If we calculate the area of that small scale, what is the formula of area? Length into breadth. We will multiply 1 by 20 into 1 by 20. It will be equal to 1 by 400 millimeter square. And what will be the volume? Again, same formula for square, area multiplied by depth. Area we have calculated 1 by 400. And depth is again the standard depth of newborn chamber, that is 1 by 10. So what will be the volume? It is 1 by 4000 cubic millimeter. Now the area of the central big scale having 5 medium size scale, it will be equal to area is equal to 1 by 5 multiplied by 1 by 5 is equal to 1 by 25 millimeter scale. And the volume, area into diameter, 1 by 25 multiplied by 1 by 10, it is equal to 1 by 250 cubic millimeter. Total number of medium size scales present in one central scale. What are these? There are in one central scale, there are 25 medium size scale, and in each scale, there are 4 divisions in both directions. There are 16 small scales. So we divide 20, we multiply 25 with the 16. This is equal to 400. RBCs are counted in the 4 corner scale and in 1 central scale. And the method of counting, I will also tell you in the next practical that where we count RBCs. But here it is sufficient that we count RBCs in 4 corner scale of this central scale and in 1 central scale. So N will be equal to N1 plus N2 plus N3 plus N4 plus N5. So there are 5 scales, each having 16 small scales. So the total number of scales in which we have to do the counting is 16 multiplied by 5, that is 80.
इसको साथ साथ फोकस किया करो ले जाओ
अगले दिन जैसे मेरे